tonight, an elderly man is in the hospital, and some crooks must have figured it out. They broke into his house.
I got an email from his daughter-in-law today. I went to Norman to check it out. What she wants to see happen is new at 6.
It's the back window where the screen is missing.
Candace Martin's father-in-law is a victim of a crime. Somebody busted into his house while he was away.
I mean, he's in the hospital.
Yeah, he's in the hospital. He went in last Wednesday night for high blood pressure and his diabetes. He has a sore on his foot. We found out that my father-in-law's wallet was missing.
In that wallet, which was right here in this bag on his scooter, money, credit cards, and medical cards.
It just seems wrong. I mean, he's in the hospital and down on his luck, and it just gets worse.
And he would not hesitate to help anybody.
Officers dusted for fingerprints, but beyond that, they haven't had any leads.
Candace tells me she'd like to see more officers patrolling these streets, but she'd also like to see more street lights. I see one light on that block. There are no street lights on this block, and there are nearly 20 different duplexes here, and at night, it is dark.
It is dark. Because they don't have those street lights.
Martina Lottie says it's a pretty quiet street and this break-in is a surprise. Candace just feels like more could be done.
Yeah, that's pretty frustrating. I mean, he goes away and now somebody's broken into the place.
A disabled person is, and the police aren't really doing anything. They don't patrol the street very much.
Well, I did talk to Norman police today. They told me on this case they don't have any new leads, but they did tell me if folks in Norman want more patrols on their streets, all you have to do is give them a call and let them know, and they will do that.